a very important and very nice question. Now, two cards are drawn from a pack of 52 cards at random and kept out. Then one card is drawn from the remaining 50 cards. Find the probability that it is a king. Now, just look what I am writing, and in the meantime, I am going to explain you also. Now, let E1 be the event of drawing two king cards, E2 be the event of drawing one king and one non-king card. And E3 be the event of drawing no king card. In the first draw of two cards. Now, what I have written, it means E1, E2, E3 be the events of drawing two cards. It is written two cards are drawn from a pack of 52 cards and keep it on one side. Now, when two cards, now what is the first chance it can be that both are king cards? Okay, then E2 can be one king and one non-king, and then E3 we are having no king and no king. So these are basically the two cards. Okay, so only this is the possibility that either both can be the kings, either both can't be the kings, or either one can be the king, one can't be the king. Okay, so that's what I have written. Now what is the probability for event 1? Now, probability for event 1 is equal to, now event 1 is 2 king cards, so total king cards are 4 C2 upon 52 C2. Now on solving, this will become 1 upon 2 to 1. Okay. Then probability for E2, now it is one is king and one is not a king, so 4C1 times 48C1 upon 52C2. So this will be on solving 32 upon 221. Okay, and the third is no king cards. So this will be 48C2, because 4 cards when they are removed, only 48 cards are left. Okay, 48C2 upon 52C2. So this will be now on solving 188 upon 221. So these are the three probabilities for the three major events. Now, let A be the event of drawing a king card in the second draw of one card. Okay, now be careful what I am writing. Now probability for A oblique E1. Now probability for A oblique E1 is, now two cards that have been drawn and that were king cards. Okay, now third card also should be a king card. Okay, so that is left, two cards are left one side. Now it is for the next event. Okay, so A oblique E1 will be now 4 minus 2 upon 52 minus 2, that is 2 upon 50. Two cards are already kings, two king cards are left from how many? From 50. Okay, then probability for A oblique E2. Now we have to find probability for only king card, no, not for any other card. So in the second attempt, what we were having? One king and one not a king. So one king already out of 50. So this is 3 upon 50. And probability for the third event, that is there were the no king cards. Okay, so total king cards are 4. Now 4 minus 0 upon 50, that is 4 upon 50. Okay, now required probability for event A, now it will be E1A or E2A or E3A. Is it clear? So now PA is equal to probability for E1A plus probability for E2A plus probability for E3A. Now PE1 A oblique E1 plus PE2 with probability of A oblique E2 plus probability of E3 times probability of A oblique E3. Now E1, 1 upon 2 to 1 times 2 upon 50 plus 32 upon 2 to 1 times 3 upon 50 plus 188 upon 2 to 1 times 4 upon 50. Now this becomes 2 plus 96 plus, now here it is 752 upon 221 times 50. Now this becomes 850 upon 850 upon 11050, or this is 1 upon 30. Hence, required probability is 1 upon 30, and this is the answer.